there, but I'm quite happy with everything going on at the moment. I've not too much pressure on. With no more hui's now, I don't need any more hui's. And just the court hearing coming up, and get through that, and we should be all ready to go.
Yeah.
Mm. Mm.
Yeah.
The first thing I'll get into really is just the, I just get something going on the land, even just a big workshop for a starter, and just get the kit set, those bolt up bits, bolt them, get them to put it up. We won't be doing any work, just manage. And whack a shed up somewhere. I'll try and get Robin Point in January, before the end of January. I'll try and get that, and then that'll be a place to set up, apart from wherever you are, what's over there. But I think I just want to get into the fisheries bit first, and get something going there. With that piece of land, because I want the architects to get on it, on all that blocks from Rodden Point back to Hicks Bay. All those blocks through there, I want to get it drawn up with single story houses right through there, and roads and workshops and whatnot, right through there. That'll be a good place to stake in, and the harbour. And the harbour, the pier and all that sort of thing. The plans that I had before, something similar, but they might have a better idea for the ship to come in there to unload, right? Redo the Hicks Bay Wharf. But I want to get away from that built-up area. I want to go, because it's locked out at a lot of point. It's still private, even the road is private. To Lawton Point from Portaka.
Yeah.
It's still a private road. See?
Yeah.
Mm. Still private land, apart from the woods. I'll go and take the woods out over there. All those people on those blocks over there. And tell them, well, we're going to put the house over there for you, and the house over there for you, and you, and you. And we're going to use all this land, and better than the cows.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They shouldn't refuse that. Just give them the house. There's a house over there, and pick a house up. See?
Yeah.
That,
up in the eastern area.
Eh?
Up in the big eastern area, mate.
Yeah, well, it's better for the Bay of Plenty area, and it's got a better route to Tonga and Samoa through there, and the Kermadec, and also to Ranfurly Bay. From that point, I wouldn't go to Rangitoto. It's too rough over there. And with the river, it floods and all that, you got all that trouble. It's a very expensive exercise. That's why the military is better than going there. Because they got the resources to do it.
Yeah.
They'll just bring all, fly all their big machines in and get in there and fix it all up and put the airport in there. So they just stay on the other side where there's rocks over there. And Lawton Point is not likely to go into the sea. That's why I like it over there. Solid, right from there around Hicks Bay. From Hicks Bay on, it's not too bad. And until you hit the river in Te Araroa, then you get the floods over there.
Right.
So I'd rather spend the investment in Lawton Point, because there's no erosion. There's no erosion, and it's deep. You're 40 metres straight off the edge of the rock, out to 2,000. Not far out. See? Yeah. So that's my first strategic point, is to go and get that motel and put a big workshop straight up there.
Yep.
Straight on the land.
Yep.
And that's the base to start from. Get the chopper, get whatever, and that's it. And park yourself over there and pick some land out, and that's the end of that.
So
there'll be plenty of things. I'll just get all. I won't worry about too much about machines or anything. We'll just get contractor to do the whole thing, do the whole works, and get employment from around the area. away from playing around with machines.
I think so.
Yeah, I don't want to go down that track and just get them in to do it and put them on a contract. That's for everything.
Yeah.
Everything on the contract. Even the turbines out and the thing, we just design and improve on ideas and then stick it into Hyundai in South Korea as a shorter distance to get them to do it first. Or China. China would be better because they can even do Cook Street in without concrete or water and just clip on the whole ship. You just buy about the tons and they just ship the whole lot out. See?
Yeah.
That's the best. And just then prepay the space, pre-sell the space, the need space in Auckland. And down below, start digging down below. And make another city underneath, for that matter, for space. That sort of thing. It's easy to just sit there and put a price on it, then tell them how much, and just sign the documents, because I think I'm not going to have any trouble signing our notes, mate. I'm just going to run the bank, that's all I'm going to do, with my little chingy Filipino girl. Not Filipino. Filipino girl, yeah. My new girlfriend's a Filipino.
Yeah, drive me nuts.
Yeah, drive me nuts, right? Drink coffee and nothing else.
Mm. Yeah.
But anyway, just a friend.
Yeah.
that's about all I can say, really, for now. And we'll just go on that over the Christmas period and mull that over.
Yeah.
Because for me, online is real. Everything there is looking like it's supposed to happen. And so all we have to do is just go and make it happen. How's Anne, all right?
Yeah.
Okay.
She had work. Still as crazy as ever.
Okay. Yeah. You're in your new place down there, or still in the same place?
What was it, mate?
You're still back in the other place? In Tauranga? No.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we're still there at the moment.
Okay, I might swing around that way when I go down. I have to just decide which day I'm going to get my car. I've got to go and take some hoses down, the ones at the back of the motor, a little hose burst and a gasket. I still got to get a gasket. I'm trying to find where to get a gasket. Payne's haven't got a gasket for that on the back of the motor, the inlet manifold. Blue. It blew. So I can't find a gasket to replace it. I might have to buy the genuine one, that'll cost heaps. Just for one hose is about $200.
What about getting the gasket and the back one?
Well, that's what they need the pattern now. It's all puckaroo, it's broken.
Yeah.
Fell to bits. The car's that old, it fell to bits and I got no pattern to take.
Well,
I don't want to take the manifold, I just left it sitting there so I can just clean it and drop it straight on and push it right on. I might get a genuine one. I might go buy the genuine one. If I can get it by itself without buying all the other bits. Yeah, otherwise it'll do me for now until I get some money if we buy a new one. Poor car is out of Ridge, it has been sitting down at Jamie's for a while now.
Which car was that one?
That's the Saab.
Oh, yeah, apparently the parts are going to be worth as much as the motor.
That's right. That's what I'm saying. I bought it for $500. The bloody hose is $200. What hose? The top what hose? So I'm just going to go and get some hoses and join them up. Like the ends, because one end's big and one end's small.
Can you not just do it or something?
No, I'm not too sure about that.
Yeah.
I'll just get a genuine one. Just in case if water spews out of anything when I screw it up.
Yeah.
If it spews out, I'll just take it down to the cellar. Now I wanna put a gasket in so it goes. Otherwise it's a good car to drive.
Yeah.
A shit hot car to fly around corners. Mm. So that's me, mate.
Yeah.
I've got to have a cup of tea now.
Yeah.
And we'll catch you anytime.
Yeah.
I'll let you know anything that's new.
Alright.
you can dig those things out for me at some stage when I go down. I'll pop up. I'll give you a call before I go to Jamie's. It might be next week.
No problem.
It'll take me a day to fix my car, but I can swing around and then I'll get some details from you and put it through the court hearing. Okay?
Yeah, well, you know, it's still probably between Coromandel and
okay. Yeah. No problem. I'll get around.
Okay.
Okay. Cheers, mate. Well, that's my mate. Kevin. The other video cut short. But he's the engineer with the brains.
He's got the brain.
Hydrogen. We're in the hydrogen again. When we get going, tell you what. Things start flying. I want to get the hydrogen planes. The Sabre. Hydrogen passenger plane. Between me and him, we can get those things flying. The British planes. So be it. British Lapcat. A4 or A2. Those are my target with the turbine energy plane. But he's got other engines. He's got water engines that are lethal. I don't want to go down that track. That's his field. I'm just sticking with the plasma engine. I've got a Moai superconducting magnetic engine. That's going to eat your heart out, mate. It will fry the heart machine. Fry a whole army. Anyway, that's my story. We'll leave it at that. I'm just going to have a cup of tea and get on with my day. Plenty to do. Today is Wednesday, the 20th of December 2017. And it was Kevin Rice, my friend, engineer, and business associate. He will be working with me and Cecile Hoots. And Kevin, his wife, has been in supermarkets for many years, so she can run our super chain on food in the Moai cooperative business. She can run our warehouses. We're going to start a warehouse for produce down the East Coast on my land blocks. We're going to get Rotten Point, the whole of Rotten Point, because that's on my title. Okay? Mr. Woods, Brian Woods, better start packing your bags, mate. I warned you this was going to happen sometime soon, because you Woods have had that block of land off my own ancestors and the Manukau's and the Rogans for fucking years. I've never been able to go and walk on those lands freely with you lot of bastards there that have tied it up in New South Wales titles. I'm sorry, you're going to get the bill. You're getting the bill for all the time that I've been blocked out of my land. 31 blocks, to be honest. Not one I can get on. Tumutumu Pairo, you got the bill. Download. Right on your fucking heads. I don't mind swearing, because I'm swearing for all the people in the world, you're screwed. In your crown corporations, thugs. If this fucking carry on, you're going to get this on your head. All of you are liable under this Manukau title. Lefa, Lefa, Manukau, and Tira Waikato, Whare Hede Hede Manukau, Whakapapa is right here, and I put it together for this country. Mr. Clausen and Mr. Woods, I put it together. You follow what I'm saying? Get off the land. That's what I'm saying. Because I want my land back off you thugs. Okay, you got it? So, Kevin, he's a Viking. He's going there to look after the lads. Because him and I, I've got something wonderful to do with those lands for all the people in the world. Not just your families. Ili. Notice he's a Pākehā. A good Pākehā. Not a fucking Lawson, Clausen, sold the property. Sold it, you mongrel bastards. The next owners that are there now, you lose it, you get your money back from Clausen's and their crooked queen, Elizabeth. That's not there anymore. She's fucked off like a good pariah. Fucked off like John Key. Fucked off. Come and screwed around here. Made a mess. Shit like a seagull. Then took off. That's what Clausen did. I wasn't going to stand and face me. And the Smith. Graham Smith, you're the fucking next. You're the fucking next. What's going to break my fucking legs? There's a whole bunch of Ngapuis want to break your fucking legs. Hmm? And a few others. Break your fucking legs. Stopping me going my fucking land. You got no title. You got fuck all. Mr. Graham Smith. You got fuck all. You'll never win in any fucking court here. Because the court's lost against me. You know why? Because you're all thugs from Australia. Convicts. That's all I want to say. Anyway, I feel good. Talk to my mate. Dion Parker Walker. Tiha. And his wife Tika took me out for breakfast. She's her people from Cook Islands. Same way my Kaika family come from Cook Islands. East Coast. Rotorua. Well, they took me out for breakfast. And we had a little chat. And I'm talking about Dion's Tainui people. He's passionate about Tainui people. He's Tainui people. But he's not very happy about what they did with Kawhiri. And screwed Kawhiri. With a fake bullshit Kawhiri. The same as all the rest of the bullshit in Kaikoura. With all those families there. I can name them. That have put their bloody titles on Auckland and shoved the fucking Manukau, whatever it is, and Te Rewaka's all about, and put their own titles there. Well, this is going to clean the fucking bodies out on the 19th of December. In fact, I'm just going to get on the phone now and ring and book the place. Just hold on. Wonderful. Yeah. And my mate, my mate. Enet Hakarai. Enet Hakarai, if I can find her number, good grief, if I can find it. I'm going to try and find it while you're on the phone. One book or another. Must be in one book. I'm going to keep looking for until I find it. And give her a ring. And book the bride. No? No? My mate, Tamati Reed, he's not on the phone. Not there. Not there. You know, every time I look and I want to find a phone number, when I want, I see every other person's number there that I don't want. Be with me. I might just come across it. Natalie Ruth Froudie Brown. That's the first man that arrested me. Carted me off into the jail. Now it's her turn to go to the jail. And for me to visit her in the jail, tell her she's a bad little girl. Bad little girl. Listing me to King. Josh the Stone. That fella never contacted me. Ever. It just tells me he's not on my side. He's got something quite different going on. Te Ongo Wakamarae. Where's her phone number? I want to ring the right one. Oh God. I need to get... phone. Just where he goes. I must put it somewhere where I can find that damn thing. I hate looking for phone numbers. Mohini Chan, that's the NZ Bank. That's the one I need to see. I better write it down. Mohini Chan. Pound notes, but she's got the pound notes in the bank. Castellina, Migos, Occidental. That's where my girlfriend lives. Jeez, I got the other flaws. Not in it. Same key. Senior bank manager. She's a senior bank manager. I've got to see her, man. I've got to see her. She's a senior. I hope she's still there, because she knows me. Buy a £1 trillion note and save millions. That's who I am. She's not here. Here it is, and it's Hakuraya. That's our camera still on. Okay. Bigger. Oh, that rang Kazir. No, that rang my number. I wonder why my phone was ringing. Because that's my number. You thought that's my phone number. I just rang my number. This her number. Her number. What do you have? I'm dawdling around here because I'm looking for a number. What do you want to hear? What do you? Hold on. I'm just using the film up. In it. Now I'm looking for Willie. Peter, I'm just going to show the phone. Yeah, no, this one. Where is he here? Messages. Messages. Where's the message? Yeah. Spark. Not a cheap object. Oh, shit. Where's all the messages? Oh, don't say they're all tuned out. Shucks, I can't find the number. That's her number there. Yeah, that's her number. Oh, well, I'll ring Paula. Come on. Paula. Go to one.
0609
a contact number and a brief message on what you're calling for. So we will get back to you. Or chapel inquiry. Please call Car Ryan on 0960 Thank you very much.
At the tone, record your message.
Hey Paula, it's John Wanawa here. I'm just trying to get a hold of Annette. Her number is 021-231-841. I just wanted to book the Marae for the 19th of January and the 20th, the Friday and the Saturday. So if she can give me a ring and book it for me. That's for a similar meeting to the last one. We had our meeting up in Tahiki. and so we're coming down to have another meeting. Won't be a big one, just a small hearing, the same. And give me a call, please. Number's 02040851042, John Wanoa. Okay, bye. There. I'll just call her. Oh, that's her number, the caller. I'll just put.
The person you're calling cannot be reached at the...
Okay. I left a message with Paula. She can let her know that I want the marae. I want the marae. What are they hearing? Again. I'm confident of having very, very inspirational hui. That serves its purpose for the people living in Auckland, in particular those people inside the Catholic Church and the Maoris that run that church in Marae. That is our the Waka Marae, in the native court, where we have our hearings for Auckland. It's a duly authorised marae for specific purposes for Maori people and anybody else for that matter who have problems with the Crown Corporations, New South Wales, New Zealand Government. Can come there and express their concerns, especially when it comes to business, land transactions, and also titles, whakapapa, and who's who on the land. Okay, we're having a court hearing. Tira Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau. Paramount Chief of Maungatauteri Mountain in Cambridge on his Kahu Punga Punga Hapu native land and his Maungatauteri Marae, ancestral lands, and his descendant Referefa Manukau, on his Manukau land, Moriori, both of them, in the Manukau Harbour. Marae is Manukau Marae in Waiuku, in the township, south side of Manukau Harbour, Upper Reaches, and also Pūponga. Marae and Pa at Pūponga Point, Manukau Heads, Cornwallis, the other Referefa Manukau, Marae. So now we have a court case, sounds like this. Tira Waikato Whare Here Here Manukau and Referefa Manukau and Maui Crown King William the Fourth Trust versus everyone else. including the landowners of Cook Street, number 77, James Pierce Brown and Simon Brent Roundtree, including Mr. John Key, living in Australia, and including the Waitangi National Trust CEO, McLeod, Chairman Peter Rowan, Ngāti Whātua o Kaipara, Te Uri Aho, Te Tau, Te Rorua, Ngāti Rāiri, Ngāti Kawa, Ngāti Kahu, tied up inside a Ngāti Whātua o Kaipara. Iwi Māori Trust and its trustees. Add to that the Rātana Church CEO from Wanganui and its conglomerate in North Island, New Zealand, including Northland, Rātana Church, Heywood Brown from Waitangi and Titi Marae, him, the Governor General, Patsy Reddy, Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern, Minister of Police Mike Bush, Navy Chief Mike, somebody, Ngāti Whārau, Runanga Iwi, trustee, CEO, Tiwana Tibo, you, the thug who I've been battling all these years with Mohi Manukau, running Ngāti Whātua o Ōraki, the CEO of Ngāti Whātua o Ōraki, you are notice, you are the others against Te Rā Waikato, Whare Here Here Manukau, and Re Whare Whare Manukau, and Māori Crown, King William IV Trust, and Ngā Aptima I Wā Aotearoa Limited, creditors, and Māori Powerhouse Group Limited, Limited Company, London, creditors, judgment creditors. You are the judgment debtor. Now, note on your head to explain your part of this fraud. Confederation of Chiefs, 1835, Declaration of Independence. That's this, goes with this, with no instructions. You're facing the 1834 play with instructions from me, the surrogate King William IV, judgment creditor and registrar of the births, deaths and marriages. Racket behind this. CRV police. In Auckland Central Police Station. You're on notice too. For this record. And of course, Judge Grant, court judge, who tried me and found me innocent and still carried on with the court case. With the police to open up the same court case with this reference, exhibit reference, Wānoa in capitals, and me as Mr. 01. Not Mr. 007, Mr. 01. Must be the first one. Yeah. Subject name. I'm a subject name called Mr. 01. Got that? Must be the first in the world. Mr. 01. So you can call me Mr. O. Okay? Mr. O carries all the legacies of a king. Mr. O has the authority, the jurisdiction and the constitution wrapped up in here in a big 970 million trillion pound note on all those people who I just named. Hicks, here's the company's office certificate of incorporation for NZ Private Police Limited. NZ Private Police Limited. Number 914119. I'm citing you. NZBN 94290378150097. This is to certify that NZ Private Police Limited is as incorporated, was incorporated under the Companies Act 1993 on this 8th day of July 1998. Private company where all the thuggery is going on. And for you, I've got this. £970 trillion note on your head. Mr. Policeman in your company, that's your bill. And each singly, with £1 trillion on your head, for doing this to me. Every one of you thugs did that to me, have got to wear that bill. All of you, and including the iwi Maori trustees. You wear that bill. And here's the invoice for all that money in ANAX, Britain, UK, right there. Okay, I've registered it as a bill debt, 970 million trillion trillion pound note to go into the British Navy military, our partner. These bills up against you. Every one of you. On this side of the video, I'm just writing it down. And it's the Ngāti Whātua area in black. You can see there. I'll put it up close, you can see. That's the province of Auckland, they call Ngāti Whātua. You can see from Taupō, below Taupō, all the way to the top of North Island, is Ngāti Whātua, this tribe they invented. So they are the New South Wales government and the New Zealand company registered in London, created that provincial title to put their magistrates' courts inside there and then call it their own. Well, that gives me enough to put up these charges up against you. And there's John Key with Bill English with the 8-point star on his coat. That there's him with the 8-point star and me somebody's fooling who? It's either he's fooling you or I'm fooling you. I'm saying the fool is not me. I'm saying it's John Keith. And if you say nothing, come the 19th of January 2018, it will become true. John Keith gets the bill on top of his head. There's £1 trillion riding on his head at the moment. Okay? He'll lose all his property, plus the balance of that will go against his queen, his boss's 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 boss. Ends up with the Rothschild banks and the Vatican and the United States of America. There's the Declaration of War flag, this flag here, 1834 right there. For the pirates, John Key, in the box here. Okay, you can see these all online. That's our evidence. The pound note with two chiefs on it. Te Re Waikato Wharehere in Manukau and Rewharewha Manukau. Te Re Waikato Wharehere in Manukau and Hongihika. Okay, on that pound note. And the gold is the gold missing. I'm the creditor of that. And that's me inside the Waitangi Marae Native Magistrate Court, where that British ship is standing in the paddock. That's my title that I'm running on with this authority to this flag. Okay? That's the end of that one. I haven't seen anybody challenge it yet. Not one. Not anyone. Come the 19th, that'll become the law. What I say inside this book is the law, with additions to it. There's the title to use in there. This is the Moriori Manukau title, right here. I'll put it together with Mohi. It's got a 500 mile economic zone to our projects with the Mana, with the Moai tidal energy power projects around the world. Okay? And that's what I'm saying, people. It's up to you to challenge it. And I'm going under all the acts of King William IV in here. And Auckland Native Grand Jury Magistrate Court, New Zealand, signed and sealed right there. Now I'm going to get these sealed documents sealed again. And that's King William's Acts seal. The Maui seal standing in London. And the chiefs and King William. So that's what I'm saying today. That's what I'm about to say. Earth Death Registration Act 1836 C86. Bankruptcy Act 1836 C27. Bankruptcy Ireland Act 1836 C14. These are some of the acts I'll be using. Letters Patent for Inventions Act 1835 C83. I've invented these things. Payment of Creditors Scotland Act 1834 C74. Insolvent Debtors Ireland Act 1834 C56. Writs of Execution Act 1833 C67. I'm quoting. I'm citing the acts against them. Police Magistrates Metropolis Act 1833 C19. William IV. Crown Lands Act 1833 C86. Bank Notes Act 1833 C83. Bank of England Act 1833 C98. These are the acts I'm using for the pound note to stick on your head. I'm using those acts because that's our acts. Our laws are here, instructions for this flag. I'm forcing it and enforcing these acts straight on top of all of you people in New Zealand, Pacific Islands, and the world. Admiralty Act 1833, C40. Admiralty, court martial law, act, I'm putting that straight on your heads. Mint Act 1831, C10. Officers of Common Law Courts Act 1831, C35. Bankruptcy Court Act, England, 1831, C56. Payment of Creditors, Scotland Act, 1831, C16. Now then, that's something for you. That's something for you. List of Crown, corporate and private companies, fraud and corrupted justice systems. These are your offences. Number one, treason. Number two, economic terrorism. Number three, fraud and deception. Number four, conspired to commit unlawful acts. Number five, murder. Number six, kidnapping. Number seven, theft. Number eight, intimidation. Number nine, crimes against humanity. Number 10, crimes against the environment. Number 11, enslavement. Number 12, wrongful arrest and conviction. Number 13, bank wars. Number 14, impersonation. Number 15, identity.